Potato, potato, tomato, tomato, let's call the whole thing off.
Lost in Translation is the title of a beautiful film, and since then we often use this phrase. To me it is more and more a political sentence in the sense of misunderstandings. And often we use it as an excuse. There's always something missing in the dialogues between different cultures. We can never really translate the specifics of language. There will be always a missing point, especially if it comes to poetry. And there is always a missing point if it comes to identities. The German mainstream culture is a network of values and taboos. But until today, German don't get it that many words which are referring to the color of skin are not acceptable. The loss in translation is a lack of experience. In this context, I understand the community who claims that a poem of an Afro-American young woman should be translated by a woman with equal cultural experiences instead of a good translator who has other experiences. Or how can African philosophers who are reflecting the consequences of colonialism know that in a German context, the discussion about colonial genocides can be easily interpreted as nearly a crime against the German Erinnerungskultur. Or German museum directors cannot understand the deeper reason why the stone objects in their ethnological collections could never communicate in their museums. Translation, which contains always a loss, depends very much on the exchange of multi-perspective views and the generosity to expect and to respect the other, including the not understandable of the other. The rules of understanding and meaning in certain contexts are dictated by a present power or the power of the present. So, lost in translation can exist also between different times within the same culture, between different ages, between different sexes. I guess we have to embrace the loss.